Pedestrians can face many dangers when crossing the road. How am I going to cross this road safely? Did you know one of the most important steps you can take to keep pedestrians safe is manage the speed of vehicles at pedestrian crossings? Consider this. If this car moves through the crossing at 42 miles per hour, there is a 50% chance that I will die if struck. As speed goes down, however, the chances of a fatal crash drop dramatically. Another issue is sight distance. As a car goes faster, the driver has less time to detect me trying to cross. If a car approaches the crossing at 45 miles per hour and the driver notices me here, this is how long it will take the car to stop. Uh-oh. At 25 miles per hour, the driver has more time to react. Many urban cities are adopting the safe system approach and have changed their posted speed limits to 20 or 25 miles per hour. Driving faster near crossings also reduces the driver's cone of vision. As cars go faster, drivers see less. Slowing down opens the cone and helps drivers see pedestrians. So how can we slow cars down prior to mid-block pedestrian crossings and save lives? Glad you asked. There are many effective countermeasures. For instance, curb extensions bring the sidewalk or curb line into the parking lane, visually narrowing the roadway and improving sight distance between drivers and pedestrians. Pedestrian refuge islands also visually narrow the roadway while allowing pedestrians to safely wait for a gap in traffic, focusing on one direction at a time. For two-lane crossings, raised crosswalks are a great option. They improve visibility by raising the pedestrian to a higher level and provide a raised platform to slow cars approaching the crosswalk. Road diets can reduce the number of through lanes and the lane width, which encourages drivers to slow down. Road diets also reduce the distance people have to cross and create space for other safety countermeasures such as refuge islands and curb extensions. Slower vehicle speeds at crossings save pedestrian lives. Contact FHWA for more information on these and other life-saving countermeasures.